Yesterday I had Derek Mickelson come by. Derek is the lead of the KRTP, the Knowledge Research Transfer Program. It's Manitoba's equivalent tech transfer program as you typically see across Canada and actually throughout North America. So we got a program running here in Manitoba. One of those services the program provides is a hygienic test. So I had Derek come by yesterday and conduct a hygienic test on my brooder yard. So I collected 15 hives. This represents the stock that I want to breed from. And we performed a hygienic test on this yard. And what I have to do now, so what we did is we froze a brood with nitrogen yesterday. And the process is I follow back the next day, which is now 24 hours later. And we want to see how much of that brood that we froze, we want to see how much of that is removed. So what I'm going to do now is proceed to go through these colonies, pull up those test frames, and take a picture of the brood, and I'll send them to Derek, and he can then further calculate the hygienic behavior within that hive. So this is hive number one. So on the first frame here, so about 20 cells, 20, 25 cells, that's what that looks like. So I will take a picture of that. And here's the second one here. So this one's cleaned out quite nicely. Take a picture of that. Digging into hive number two. So it looks like they're very active on chewing away the cells. So I'm not sure what qualifies as a cleaned out cell. I guess if the cells are completely cleaned out. So they're actively chewing at it, so that's good. Digging into hive number three. These bees are definitely at the brood to clean it away. So this is much more cleaned out than this one over here. So they've paid a lot of attention towards it. Hive number four. A lot less chewed away. So this one hardly any, just a bunch there. Both are about the same. So hive number four isn't as hygienic. Hive number five. Definitely at that patch. A couple more hours, I bet you that's cleared out. Oh, here's the other one down here. Still larvae in there, or pupae, I mean. Tops are all taken off, and they're actively pulling them out. So another few hours, these would be cleaned right out. Hive number six. Chewing away at the cappings, but not all removed yet. They're sure paying attention to it. I bet you a few more hours they'd be cleaned out. Boy, this is looking promising. Even the worst ones are still, they're still showing attention to it. Hive seven. There's a ticket. This one's completely cleaned out. One pupae left in there. This side's practically cleaned out. One, two, three, four, five left. This is a hygienic hive. Look at that. That's 24 hours. They've actually started storing nectar in there. Lucky number 7. Who is this? This hive. Jack of Diamonds. Lucky number 7. 3 years of excellent performance. This shows me there's been 3 years of taking splits from this colony. And it's been going since 2014. Boy, she's been around for a while. Not her. This hive has succeeded since 2014. And then this is a mark of brilliance. So this is definitely going to be a candidate for our breeding program. Hive 8. Hive 8's not as hygienic. Hardly any attention to these patches. Just a little bit. Working in Hive 9. Here's some hygienic behavior here. Lots of cells taken out there. Lots of cells taken out there. Nice and cleaned up. It's Hive 10. All right. Paying attention to these cells also. Lots of brood removed. Going through Hive 11. Okay, this one is not showing as much attention to the brood. Hive 12. This one is, they've paid attention to all the brood, removing it. I bet you in a few more hours that'd be cleaned right out. My selection, my breeder selection right now is very applied, very basic. It's working extremely well. I just keep promoting the strong and the ones that just make me happy and make me money. But adding this hygienic behavior test just adds a layer of professionalism to my whole selection criteria. And it just brings on a whole different dimension on what I want to do. I want to propagate the hygienic type bees. I want the ones that will, in some sense, manage the disease issue on their own. And this is just the start of it. Selecting for hygienic behavior, you know. Maybe we could start selecting for grooming behavior. Maybe we could start selecting for VHS behavior. I mean, what else do we want? We can just add layers to the program and just bring out whatever we're looking for within our stock. Look at that, hardly any attention. Just a little bit of attention to it. I'll probably call this one out. Hive 13. Not as much. Capping's taken off. Still pupae in the cells. Last one, Hive 15. Oh, this is a good one. Look at that. That's 100%. That is completely gone. There's nothing left. There are just a little bit chewed up pupae in there. Holy, that is beautiful. This one is going to be picked for a breeder hive for sure. So 15. You are a 15. Showing four there? No, it's just three tags of strong hives coming out of winter. So I've been able to take three strong splits from this colony. Marked it as a breeder. Ace of clubs. You know, there you go. So this one for sure. So with that, I'm finding 15 and 7 are my most hygienic hives within this yard of 15. And there's a good tendency of hygienic behavior within this yard alone. This is off the top of my head, there's three for sure that not really paying much attention to that dead brood. But all the rest, we're actively pursuing removing that pupae out of the cells. Active. I bet you if I come back 24 hours from now, there wouldn't be many that would have the brood still in the comb. So 24 hours is a pretty tight timeline if you ask me. So these hives had to have directed their attention towards that dead brood almost instantly, and they've been busy removing that dead brood. There you go. So I'm going to email those off to Derek tonight, and I'm going to get him to score them right away. So then tomorrow, Carrie did graft from that 7 hive, and 15 is another sure candidate, so she can graft from that tomorrow. So it just depends on when Derek can give me the results, and I'll be selecting the top 5 or 7 from this yard.